your girl over in the corner, yes, she jockey.
Come on.
All you gotta do is put your hands up and rock. Don't be scared, little mama, you got you.
Yeah, now this your funky. Two of the man with a plan, my boy's up on it. Ain't that what we called it? Why y'all guys out here stalling while we ride the bike? Can't see really be digging me.
You left at 7:46. It is now, what time is it? 8:39. This is ridiculous. You've wasted the entire class period, and no one else could pee. How do you feel about that? Terrible. Terrible is the correct response. It's terrible, and you're wasting your education.
It's a TY production.
Riding on my way to the top. All I want is hundos. Riding on my way to the top. Got big cause I want those. Riding on my way to the top. All I want is hundos. Riding on my way to the top. Got big cause I want those.
How's it going, viewers? And welcome to my Fireside Chat. Currently, we're in December, and what else are we going to think about other than the holidays? Specifically, Christmas, Kwanzaa, Hanukkah, New Year's, and any other traditions you celebrate at this time. It really takes your mind off the cold weather. Though, it doesn't bother me, since I have this totally real fire. So, sit down, let's begin the Fireside Chat. On top of fires, you know what's fueling this one? Yule log. There's typically two known forms of Yule logs, one being a delicious log-shaped cake, which is not the kind of fuel of this fire, because that would be a huge waste of delicious food. The other type of Yule log is the one that's actually in the fire. is usually used in modern Christmas tradition in several European countries, with some interesting folklore and history behind it. You want to know more? Look up yourself and explain more if I had the time, but sadly, I do not. Next, let's talk about menorahs. You typically associate them with Hanukkah, but Kwanzaa has their own version of the menorah, with each candle representing the seven principles of Kwanzaa that are as follows: unity, self-determination, collective work, responsibility, cooperative economics, purpose, creativity, and faith. Moving on, all of you are aware of the traditional stockings hung up over fireplace on Christmas morning, but why? Well, it dates back to the tale of St. Nicholas. So let me tell you an abridged version of the story. Long ago, there lived a poor man and his three very beautiful daughters. With no money to get them married, and the worry that he would be poor, they would be poor and desperate after his death. St. Nicholas was passing through when he heard talk of the girls. He decided to help in secret since the man wouldn't accept charity. So he threw three bags of gold through a window of the family's house. Each bag ran directly into his stockings, hanging near a fireplace to dry. And from that day forward, it became tradition for children to hang up stockings and put out shoes, eager waiting gifts from St. Nicholas. So I have for now. See you next time, Lansdowne.
Five things to do with Cheerios. Make a bracelet. Two, play tic-tac-toe.
Bam! 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 What bam?
Three, use your face to catch the Cheerios.
What are your kids up to now?
Four, make earrings. Five, try to get them in your mouth without using your hands.
That's all the time we have for the fun stuff on video this month on the Lansdowne Show. Hope you stay warm and tune in for next month's Look at the Lansdowne, right here at the Lansdowne Show.
I thought I was hosting.
Well, you thought I was funny, so how's this for funny? This has been your host, Jimmy, saying see you next month on the Lansdowne Show.